In this lecture, we want to talk about first uniqueness theorem of primary decomposition. So again, we start with the remark, let Q be P primary, which essentially means that if AB lies in Q, either A lies within P or B lies within Q or both of them. And recall that Q is a primary ideal. Q be P primary means that Q is a primary ideal and radical of Q is this P, which is the underlying prime ideal. So this P is prime. So let us now construct a new object for an ideal Q and some element X in ring R. We can write this ideal Q over X as all the elements of the ring such that AX lies within the ideal Q. So first thing to notice is that QX is an ideal which contains Q. So obviously if you take elements of Q and you multiply with something, they will still lie within Q. So all the elements of Q lie in here precisely because of the property of the ideal. You multiply with something, it will still lie in here. So this ideal at the very least contains Q. And it is equal to R if X is in Q, again by the property of the ideal. If you take this X which is already lying in Q, because under multiplication there is closure of ideals, you multiply any elements like this, they will always lie in Q if X to begin with lies within the ideal Q. This because of the property of the ideal. So this is also important. So at the very least you contain this ideal Q, and it becomes the entire ring R if you pick up this X lying in our ideal Q. So the first lemma we want to discuss is this. So let Q be a P primary ideal where X lies in the ring R but it does not lie within Q. So that lies outside this ideal Q. Then this Q over X is P primary. So this is what we want to show. Q over X is P primary. So essentially we will also have to end up showing is the radical of Q over X is P. So let's start. Let's start proving it. So first thing we're going to show is this. Radical of Q over X is P. So this is the first thing we will show. So let Y lie in this Q over X, which essentially means that XY lies within Q. Just copying the definition down right here. But X is not in Q because we are picking up X which is outside Q but within the ring R. So therefore Y has to be in P. So now we are using this definition right here. So if AB lies in Q, either A is in P or B is in Q. And since we are making sure the second element does not lie in Q, so the first element has to. So here we are saying that X does not lie in Q, so it has to be the case that Y is in P. So therefore Q is a subset of this Q over X, which in turn lies within P. That is because you pick up any Y in Q over X, any Y here, and we have shown that that Y also lies within P. And we have the first statement is that Q over X naturally contains Q. So this is how the statement is. So this we have just shown right now. You picked up Y in Q over X, it lies within P. Now you take radicals. If you take radical, you get radical of Q over X, you get radical of, so you take radicals here, you get radical of Q lies within radical of Q over X, but P is prime, so radical of P would be just P. But we start with Q as a P primary ideal, so this is also P. So you have radical of Q over X, it contains P and is contained within P, so it has to be equal to P. So this is shown. So the second thing we want to show is that Q over X is primary. So for that what we are going to do is we are going to start with YZ in Q over X, and this is P primary. This is what we have to show. So YZ in Q over X with Y does not lie in P. So first element doesn't lie, so it has to be the case that we have to show the second element lies in. So Y is not in P, and we will end up showing that Z lies within Q over X. So let us see this. So we are saying YZ is in Q over X. That means because there is X here, so XYZ lies within Q just by this definition here. Now this implies x z lies within Q, precisely because we are saying is y does not lie in P. So this does not lie within P, so the other two elements x z has to lie in Q. Now if x z lies in Q, that immediately implies that z lies in Q over x, because that's what implies that x z lies in Q. Meaning of x z is in Q is that z lies in Q over x. And that's what we wanted to show. Now let us define associated prime ideal of this ideal I. So this associated prime ideal of this ideal I, this can be written as radical of I over x for some x in the ring R. So the set of such prime ideals is called associated prime ideals of I, and they are denoted by this associated of I. So again, associated prime ideal of ideal I is written as radical of I over x for some x in R. And the set of such prime ideals, these are called associated prime ideals of I. So the first uniqueness theorem of primary decomposition. So consider a primary decomposition like this. So I you can write as Q1 intersection Q2 all the way to Qn, where each of these Qi is Pi primary. So that is radical of Qi is Pi, and each of these Pi is prime. So then the associated prime ideals of I are precisely P1, P2 all the way to Pn. So the number of components, so there are n components as you can see here, P1, P2, P3 all the way to Pn. So the number of components in the minimal primary decomposition does not depend upon the chosen decomposition. So in this chosen decomposition, there could be say m elements instead of n, there could be m elements. And the idea is that some of these elements might have repeated underlying prime ideals. So you take radical of some of those ideals here, they might have same underlying prime ideals. So these underlying prime ideals are not going to change. They are irrespective of the number here, the number of components here, the number of components here is irrespective of the decomposition you choose here. And that is what the first uniqueness theorem says. So first direction, so we are going to show in this direction. So this direction is like this. So since the decomposition is minimal, so this we are saying is a minimal decomposition, we can always find x in intersection of j not equals to I qj. So x lies in all these qj's except one of the qi's. Okay, so you can find such an x because our decomposition is minimal. So now what we do is you take this I over x here. So this I over x will be equal to q1 over x intersection all the way to qn over x. So that just is a fact, you take it as a fact. Then you take radical of both sides, then you can take the radical inside. That is true for any ideals. If you have intersection of ideals I1 intersect I2 all the way to In, you take radical outside, that comes inside. Now this x lies in Q1, x lies in Q2, only thing is x does not lie in Qi, then all the way to x lies within Qn. Now if x lies within this ideal Q, this entire thing Q over x is equal to R. So for all these, this Q1 over x, you take its radical, this is just R, radical of R will just be R, all of this will be R, except for the corresponding Qi over x, because x does not lie within Qi. So if x does not lie within Qi, you have this radical of Q over x is P. So here in our case it would be Pi, because Qi is Pi primary. So you just have Pi here, you take R intersection R, we just have Pi here and everything else is R, so you just get Pi. So Pi lies within the associated prime ideal of I, precisely because radical of I over x is of this form Pi. And associated prime ideal of I, they are written as radical of I over x, and this is the one of the prime ideal. So this Pi lies within associated prime ideals of I. So now we show it in the other direction. So let P lie within associated prime ideals of I. So that means by definition radical of I over X is P for some X in R. So there could be more than this also. So we are saying that radical of I over X is just a prime ideal. So this is a prime ideal. So then P is radical of I over X. This is just radical of QI over X all the way to QN intersection radical of QN. So this is just you're copying this right here. So essential idea is that you're writing I over X is Q1 is 2X intersection Q2 over X intersection all the way to QN over X. So this you get from right here. So again we have just copied this down, but this is a prime ideal and this is an intersection. So since this is a prime ideal, there are two things. So first thing is that prime ideal would lie in one of them. So P would be lying within radical of QI over X. In fact, it is lying in all of them. So P lies in all of them. But since this is prime, at least one of these would be also lying within P. So P contains some radical QI over X, but P also lies within radical of QI over X. And therefore, P is equal to radical of QI over X. So we have this containment right here. And that's what we wanted to show. So thus, we have proven the first uniqueness theorem.